Time is 8:30, and we come to Saturday Night Theatre.
The Fallow Land, the novel by H.E. Bates, adapted for radio by David H. Godfrey, with Denise Breyer as Deborah and Jeffrey Matthews as Jess. The Fallow Land.
Gents, and try your luck. What about you, sir? Have a go.
All right. I'll have 6 pence.
That's it, sir. Never know your luck, do you? Here you are, sir.
Thanks. Here we go, then. No. No. Nearly. No. Oh, hey, does that count?
Right, not, sir. They got to be right over.
Oh, one more. Here goes. No, me luck's out.
Have a go for me. For a necklace.
Eh? I'm afraid my luck's out.
Never say die. What about that green necklace? Have a go for me. Here's my sixpence.
Sixpence? I'd be shot if I didn't man enough to do a little thing like that. Another 6 pence, please.
That's the spirit, sir. Here you are, sir.
So, well, here goes.
Nearly. A little further to the left.
Hey, easier said than done. No.
Never mind. You'll do it.
How's this?
Well done!
It's a necklace, isn't it?
One necklace, sir.
Oh, well, thank you. Don't wear it myself, but this young lady will.
Oh, thank you. I've been wanting a green necklace for a long time.
If I couldn't win a bit of a thing like that with you egging me on, I wouldn't be a mucher.
Oh, you made my heart stop beating, throwing like you did.
Huh?
I could see you wasting every penny just for the sake of wasting it.
Money and everything.
You can't do a sight without it. I can't bear to see folks throwing money down the gutter. I'd take care of what bit I got.
You're like my old dad. He wraps his up in some old bag and hides it.
He'd have a fit of you throwing money away like you do, wouldn't he, then?
He'd have a fit anything I did, I reckon. Hey, but look, instead of standing here and talking, we might be having a glass of beer. Or ride on them peacocks.
Oh, it's just money thrown away on peacocks, I think.
Yeah, I could do with a glass of beer, anyhow. Don't know about you.
I could do with a bit of a sit-down. But I don't want more than half a glass.
Come along, then. This is a queen's way. Pass a fortune teller. Oh, that's better.
I look well, I warrant. Sitting here with a stranger, don't I?
You're all right. Your mother won't see nothing.
It'd puzzle my mother to say much. And my father, too. They'd been buried long enough.
It's a wonder I didn't lose you in the crowd when we left the oop last, though. You like some little dilling pig, you are.
What's a dilling pig?
And a litter of pigs is always a little mite. That's what a dilling is. We always feed the dillion up a bit, if the sow don't lay on it. I reckon that's what we better do with you, too. While we sit here talking, we might be eating a mite of brandy snap.
Oh, I couldn't eat a crumb.
You couldn't? Well, let's have about a two on the peacocks and then eat something.
You won't rest till you drag me on those peacocks. I know, you aren't tatter, you are.
Yeah.
Oh, I don't know. It's throwing your money in the street. But I'll come. Just once.
There we are. Now, which would you rather, a peacock or a swan?
Oh, a swan. Somehow I could never trust the look of a peacock. It's all show and nothing else.
Did you ever see a string of swans flying over?
No.
When we were ploughing, day before yesterday, a string went squawking over. They're pretty to look at, flying.
Are you a farmer, then?
Well, we got a bit of land, such as this. Two, please. Thank you. Now, let me give you a hand. We're off, hey! Hold on! What's a fiddling bit of a ride like that? You don't know as you've had it.
You know what it's like when you've had one as well as when you've had a dozen. It's a measly bit of a ride for tuppence, though.
Ah, second ride's the best. Besides, what's tuppence? Here we go again, oi! What's your name?
Deborah.
Deborah what?
Deborah Lovefly. What's yours?
Jess. Jess Mortimer.
I don't know what you think, Jess Mortimer, but you've thrown away enough money on this thing. Off we get, quick.
Take me on, then. Jump.
Thank you.
All right.
Now, come along. Don't stand there looking at it. Wouldn't take long at that rate to spend a week's wages whirling round.
Oh, depends. What you call a week's wages?
I get 5 shillings and all found.
Oh? What doing?
I'm in service. Mrs. Arbuthnot's in Wildbriar Lane.
Wildbriar Lane, eh?
Oh! That's 11 o'clock.
No matter. How about a hot potato? Store's just across there.
No, I'm sorry. I can't stop. I ought to have been in not a minute after 10, and here I am.
Well, if you must go, you'd better take this buttonhole I've been wearing.
Oh.
There you are. Goes well with them beads.
Thank you, Jess. Good night.
If you'd like to come up to the farm Sunday afternoon, we could have a bit of a look round for mushrooms. How'd you like to come?
I'd love to, but you'd have to fetch me.
Oh, I'll fetch you.
About 3 o'clock.
Eh, that'll be fine. I'll be there.
Mrs. Arbuthnot?
Hmm?
I brought your tea, Mrs. Arbuthnot.
Hmm. Oh, well, help me up, can't you? I'm standing there like a dummy, you fool. Help me up. I can't drink lying on my back, can I? Help me up.
Now, take it gently, Mrs. Arbuthnot.
Gentlier. I might die while you stand there. Why don't you use your wits? You'd like to choke me, wouldn't you? I know.
Now, drink your tea, Mrs. Arbuthnot.
You've poisoned it.
Oh, what a story. Oh, what a wicked thing to say.
You've poisoned it. What have you put in it? Tell me what you put in it. Well, why don't you answer me?
It's just a nice cup of tea, madam, that's all. Why, I drink it myself. Come, taste it again. Mm. It's your fancy.
Fancy.
Come now. Drink it while it's still hot.
Ugh. I don't like it. It's queer. Well, don't stand there. Bring me my shawl and put it round my shoulders.
Yes, madam.
Well, what are you doing there? Come away at once. Come away from that wardrobe, I tell you. I know. You're after something there. You want to steal something. First you want to poison me, now you want to rob me. Well, if you're not trying to steal, why don't you say so? Oh, where are you? Oh, don't go. Don't leave me for a moment. Come here. Mm-hmm. That's it. Stand there.
Yes.
You didn't hear anything in the night, did you?
No.
something walking about and sighing. I know I heard it. A man's voice and something moving up and down. Didn't you hear anything?
No, Mrs. Arbuthnot.
I know I heard something. I woke up. It wasn't a dream. I woke up and felt he was in the house.
Felt who was in the house, madam?
My son, Leopold, of course. The son I lost. He was in the house. He was walking up and down.
Oh, Mrs. Arbuthnot, you was having a dream, that's all. You were only dreaming. You'll work yourself up into such a state again, you won't be able to write your poetry. What are you going to write about today?
Huh? Oh, yes, yes. About the leaves. Ah. About the autumn. October, with her sweet and faded face, majestic in her form of molded grace. I should begin like that. I thought of it in the middle of the night when I woke up. Oh, are you sure you didn't hear anything?
Of course I didn't. Now, you lie quiet. You won't be worth a hatful of crabs if you don't. That's better. I'll just go and get your breakfast.
Up to the farm Sunday afternoon, we could have a bit of a look for mushrooms. How'd you like to come?
I'd love to, but you'd have to fetch me.
I'll fetch you.
About 3 o'clock?
That'll be fine. I'll be there.
Look, what's this one?
Hey? That's only an old puffball. I trample on them, I do. They ain't no good. And those you're carrying are what we call blue legs.
I'm a fine mushroomer, no mistake. Why can't I find them?
You'll soon catch on. Hey, now don't throw the blue legs away. Oh. The old dad will be glad of them.
Oh, am I going to meet a lot of folks?
Or the old mum and dad.
Haven't you any brothers or sisters or anybody?
No.
What does your mother say about my coming?
Nothing. She wouldn't say nothing to what I'd done. Through his gate, yeah. This way. I need your mum in the kitchen.
Poor man, you urge me. If you're going to put some wood on, put some wood on. Putting skinny flint bits like that. Now, what heat is there in bits like that?
Hello, Mum. Dad.
Oh.
Yeah.
Hello, right. Jess.
Mum, I want you to meet Deborah Loveday.
Oh. Afternoon, miss.
Good afternoon.
And this is my dad. We be mushrooming. She's brought a tidy handful of blue legs, Dad.
Blue legs, hey? Milking done, Jess?
Not yet, Dad. Just going along.
Tea's pretty near ready. Now don't go off, Jess.
Tea'll have to wait, that's all. Cow's got to be milked. Be dark helps.
We'll wait for you, Jess.
Loveday, eh? You ain't no kin of J.B., Loveday. Big man, a carrier, used to talk down his nose. They used to twit him a lot about talking down his nose.
I got no relations, much.
They used to work with a man named Loveday.
Oh, you starting to fill the girl's head with your old tales afore she's been in the house 5 minutes, I would. I wonder how many more times now, I wonder.
Oh, shut up.
Folks will think you've nothing else to do but sit and tell fool's tales like that. They can fetch some wood in, that'd make more sense, like.
Jess says you eat blue legs, Mr. Mortimer.
Oh, he'd eat any old truck. Stinking old herbs, I don't know what he'll bring home some days and stew them. Fit to choke a polecat.
Oh, mash the tea, woman. I want to get locked up before dark.
Mash the tea whenever Jess gets in and not until. Oh, leave off with that poker!
All right.
Jess will be here in a minute. I expect you're hungry, my dear, but we always waits for Jess.
There's a basket of things Dad's put up for you to take home.
Oh, that's very kind of him.
There's some pears and walnuts. And he says next time you come, he wants to know how you like the blue legs. Yeah. Some of them in there too. How'd you like our old farm, Deborah?
Oh, I like it. And your dad.
Come up again next Sunday.
I'd love to.
Hey, come here.
Oh, Jack. Your place.
My mother's by the bed. Can you come up now?
Of course, I was just leaving. Mrs. Arbuthnot's asleep.
I'm fit about, Mum. I'm straight.
Come on in a moment. It's cold on the step. But what is it?
Well, she was drawing water from the well this morning. Yeah. Just as we were sitting down to breakfast, me and Dad, there was such a rattling and clanging out in the yard. Must have been the bucket rattling down the well again. Well, we went out and there she lay, groaning. I never heard anybody groaning like her. Straight, I'm frit about her.
Well, what does the doctor say?
We ain't had no doctor.
Why not?
She won't. She won't have a doctor in the house for love nor money.
Oh, dear, I don't know some folks. We'd best get up to the farm now and see what can be done. I'll get my things first.
It's Deborah, Mum. Is your side hurting you?
Oh, it don't hurt now. I seem a lot better. I shall try and get up after tea.
You'd better stay in bed, Mrs. Mortimer, and let Jess fetch a doctor.
No, I don't want a doctor. I don't want no doctor's trips up and down. Where's he gone? I heard him go out. Picking the herbs again, I warned. He ain't gone for a doctor, has he? I don't want a doctor.
Dad's out of feeding up, Mum. That's all right.
Well, I don't want a doctor anyway. Now, do you hear me?
That's all right. I shall have to go down and milk, but Deborah, she'll stay with you. You lay quiet, don't fret. Try and have a bit of a sleep, then.
I will. Deborah?
Yes, Mrs. Mortimer?
Put your hand down here. Mm-hmm. Down my side. No, lower down. There. That's it.
There's a lump.
I know. I know. It worried me a bit. It's been there a good while.
A good while? Mm. How long?
Oh, I don't know, justly. It's them old wet stones round the well. I slipped. Caught my side on the winch handle. I did it once before, back in the summer. Tain't nothing much, is it?
I don't rightly know. I think you ought to have a poultice or something before it gets worse. I'll go down and get one hot for you.
Deborah?
Yes, Mrs. Mortimer?
Come here a minute.
Yeah?
Don't say nothing to Jess. Whatever you do, will you? I ain't said nothing to him. Don't say nothing to him, will you? I shall be all right, though. I'd be all right.
Well, what is it, girl? Don't stand there like a dummy. Say what you've got to say and have done with it. Has anything happened?
No, Mrs. Arbuthnot, ma'am.
Then what is it?
I want to leave, ma'am. I want to give notice.
You want to what? Oh, you're not going to leave me.
I'm going to be married, ma'am.
Good God. I didn't know you had... Why is it so sudden? What's happened? Has anything happened?
His mother has just died, Mrs. Arbuthnot. He and his father are alone and... Oh, I'm afraid it is a bit sudden, but I...
What is he?
He's a farmer.
Farmer. Well, if you want to go, you'll have to go, I suppose. There's nothing I can do.
Then you take my notice, ma'am.
A farmer. There's no money in farming, never was. Has he got money?
I'm sure I don't know what he's got. Not much, I dare say.
Then you ought to know. Money's most important. It's no use entering on married life without money. You'll want children, I expect, won't you?
Oh, I expect so.
Do you know anything about having children?
Well, ma'am, I know.
I dare say. But do you know anything about not having them?
I don't know what you mean.
Mm.
I thought not. Well, before you get my tea, I want you to look in the top left-hand drawer of the chest and give me the box in there.
Very well, Mrs. Arbuthnot.
That's it. Now, fetch me a pen. Hurry, girl. That's it, and the ink. Now then, I'm determined to see you're not penniless when you start. Now, this check is for you. There. £30. I put it there to dry.
Mrs. Arbuthnot!
Oh, be quiet, girl. I haven't finished yet. Now, this ring is quite hideous, but it's valuable. It's yours also. Oh. A girl who has the courage to marry a farmer needs something behind her. Oh. Now you may get my tea.
Yes, Mrs. Arbuthnot.
Deborah, that fella land will take such a deal of cleaning afore it's ready for cropping. But I've said my say a dozen times. I got that calf to attend to. I'll leave you in Jess to chew it over.
Why don't you try something new in it, Jess?
Something new?
Yeah, something you never tried before.
What ain't we tried, I should like to know.
Well, I'd try again, then. I'd never see a good field like that go to waste.
A good field, did you say?
If it was the only field you'd got, you'd have to make it do.
Oh, yeah, I dare say.
Well, all I can say is you'll have to try something soon. Your son won't always feed on milk. There. He's a right to live as well as anybody. Why don't you think about him? And break that field up for something?
Aye, keep on about it. You and that fallow field.
Yeah, me and that fallow field, if you like. But if it was cultivated once, it can be cultivated again, I know.
You know such a lot about it. What shall we try?
Well, you might try sugar beet.
Sugar beet? Oh, the papers. Don't you believe all you read in the paper?
Well, it's something you never tried anyhow. And there's a paper offering free seed and prizes for the biggest beet.
Oh, yeah, we should get a prize, all right.
You've no faith, and that's what's wrong with you. If you believed you could do it, you could do it. No man alive could stop you.
What do you think just Dad and me could do?
I know it's hard, but if it's too much, why don't you hire a man and buy another horse?
Man and a horse? The deal do you think we can get money from to get a man and a horse?
You might as well know it first as last.
Know what?
Your mother left you a little money.
Oh, yes, I know. How much? 18 pence. Anyway, how do you come to know what she left? It'll be a fat lot anyway. Now for a pint and a smell. That's about all. I'm off out. Are you said anything to Dad?
I'm sure I haven't said a word to a soul.
Where is it?
Still where I found it. In that big chest that belonged to your mother. It's safe enough.
Why didn't you tell me before?
But it slipped my mind.
Slipped your mind? Let's have a look at it. I don't believe it till I see it. Fetch it out. Let's have a look at it.
I've got something else to do besides thinking about money, I'm sure. This for a start.
Anyhow, how do you know it's for me?
Because it says so. Here, hold David for me a moment. Hey? I'll fetch the money once and for all. Here, what will you take him?
I am taking him as fast as I can.
Why don't you like him? He's your own flesh and blood. He won't bite you. Why don't you take to him?
Nothing taking about him.
So you think? You ought to be ashamed of yourself, that's all I can say.
Hey, what's the matter? What are you bawling like that for? I'm your dad!
What on earth are you doing to him? Here's your money. Now rest yourself. Now, for mercy's sake, give the child to me. There, there, there.
Where'd you get this box?
I told you. The big chest that belonged to your mother.
sovereigns. Every jack one of them, sovereigns. It's a card with my name on it, too. How much is it all together?
You'd better count it.
How the Hanover did she do it?
She's the only one who knows that. Look. He's watching you, Jess. He knows every movement you make.
Yeah. Know what that is, young fella? Play with that, then. Go on. Take it. Yeah, you throw it down, would you? Throw it down again. Go on.
Oh, you'll lose it.
No, I've tried it. Yeah.
You'll keep on till you lose it.
What matter? There's all of £150 here. He can have it. Here, our son. Have another throw. Your mother won't know. And again.
Oh, Jess, you great fool.
Yeah, see? Go on, do it again.
Mrs. Mortimer?
Yes?
Your man's had a bit of an accident.
Oh, the great loony. Where is he? What's happened?
He's out here. We're bringing him in. He got thrown from a trap.
A trap? Whose trap? He never went out in a trap.
The horse shied at a fallen tree. Your tea is on, will you, darling? Right.
Come on, Jess. Yeah. That's it.
Right there. Well, you can soon be all right now, ma'am.
Thank you. I'm most grateful.
All right, ma'am. Glad you well. Good night.
Yeah. Right. Night, Ben, Dove. All right. See you Saturday.
You'll be all right.
Yeah, of course. Don't be late and take care of that head.
Right.
Oh, you great half-sharp. What have you been trying to do?
Nothing. Hey, get me some brandy.
All right, then. Lean back. There you are. Now drink that. How the goodness gracious did you come to do this?
Oh, a ruddy horse had a fit, that's how.
Is your arm broken?
Oh, what the hell do you think?
You're about half sharp, that's what I think. You must have been drunk, the lot of you. You'd better go to bed. Come along. What's the matter with your head?
Nothing. Well, shut up. Leave me alone. I'm getting a bit about myself.
But Jess...
Leave me alone, I said! Leave me alone!
Mine. Whose do you think?
Yours? Why, how's that? You haven't bought it.
What do you think I did? Picked it off a tree?
You'll come to grief one of these fine days, my man.
Oh, man.
Yeah, you sneer. You den a sneer at me when I first met you.
Ah.
What made you buy a horse like that? It's no good on the land. What do you think you're going to do with it now you got it?
Ride it. What the blazes do you think?
You're well enough to ride a horse, but you won't carry a swill bucket or put the plough to that fallow land.
Ah, oh, you don't know what you're talking about, woman. Get up, girl. Go on.
Good afternoon. Promised I'd be here, didn't I? Nice little violets you've got. Noticed them by the spinney as well.
Well, did you?
Primrose is coming out too.
What you been doing to yourself?
Breaking my neck. I don't know who's the prettiest, the violets or the one who's getting them.
You got a fine horse.
I'll give it to you.
You will?
Said I would. There you are. What's your name?
Alma. Alma Wollstoneholm.
Oh, a nice name. Well, there's your horse. Can you ride?
No.
Would you like to ride?
Oh, yes.
Come on, then. I'll teach you. Here. Put your foot in the stirrup. Catch hold of me. Yay, where we go. She don't know you yet. She'll be all right. Put your foot in the stirrup. That's it. Now, get up. There. How'd you feel?
I don't know what you'd think if I told you.
Yeah. You ready?
Yes.
That's it, easy. Don't pull her. Just sit easy and let her take you. I've got you.
So it seems.
You wouldn't like to fall, would you?
Not yet.
Careful now.
Jeff, we're not half through cutting this bean crop yet, and it's only half an hour till sundown.
I've had enough, that's all.
Do you think your father and I haven't too? If we don't get this crop in tonight, we won't even get back the price of our seed.
You won't be. Said I've had enough. I'm off.
Not if I know it, you're not. And I don't care who she is. This bit of beans come before any little bitch of a barmaid.
Barmaid? Clever dick.
Well, whatever she is...
Yeah, what's your game? You let go of me.
You're coming back.
Who says so?
I say so. When this field is clear, you can do your dirty business. Not until... Come on. Get that sickle.
Let go of my arm. Let go of my arm, you hear me? Oh, I warn you, it'll be the worst for you.
You. That's about all you're fit for.
I've had about enough of this. Ow! You'll be lucky if you ever see me in this hole again.
You... You turn up like a bad penny.
Bad of it.
Yes, what's up? Where are you going?
She knows, Dad. Better ask her.
Boy, what's the matter, Deborah? Yes, you mustn't weep. Yes! Yes! Come back here. Come back here at once.
I'll let him go, Dad. He's not worth it. Let's get on. We must get these beans in before dark.
What is it? Little brat, shut up. You hear me? Dad, keeping on. What's the matter with you?
Dad, I...
All right, Davy, my lad. You take that. See how you like it. Yeah, well, perhaps that'll cure you. Yes, you can bowl. Well, go bowl to your grandfather. Why can't you show some spirit like your brother? Hey, that's the spirit, young Benjamin. That's the spirit. Hey, I'll give you a sovereign if you do it again. No, never mind you fall over. Make a man of you. That's it. Bloody good. Hey, you'll have a sovereign when I put my best trousers on.
Bloody, bloody.
Oh, you young devil. Hey, come here. Now, say it again if you dare.
Bloody, bloody. That's a nice word.
What if it is? At least young Benji's a man, not like his milksop of a brother.
So that's all you can find time to teach him.
I'll learn him another, if you ain't careful.
I can well believe it.
Oh, you can you? Here. Say blast it. Benji, say blast it so as your mother can hear.
Once and for all. And listen, I shan't say it again. You may do what else you
now
like, but...
Now, preach.
Very well. You know well enough what I'm trying to say. These children shall grow up a credit to me if they never do to you. Get that into your head.
Ah, hear that, you young devil. There's a woman for you.
Blast it, blast it. Grandad.
Yeah, I say, this won't do, young David. You must just let Grandad finish the milking, and then we'll have a story. Eh? This is the last bit. There we are, Rosie. Good girl. Now then, David, let's have a sit on this hay, shall we?
Yes, Grandad.
That's better. Now then, what story shall we have?
The one about the magic lake.
The magic lake? Oh, yes. Well, now, once upon a time, there was a big old house.
Was it quiet there?
Oh, yes, 'twas very quiet. And behind the house, in a beautiful garden, was a beautiful lake.
Was that the magic lake?
That's right, David. And when the moon come up, big and yellow, you could see its reflection in the clear, smooth water, like a great, big, yellow plate. It was all very peaceful.
I want it! Me! Give me it!
Here, where do you think I am, out in the spinney?
I want it!
You'll do as I say.
No!
I'll teach you to snatch. You shall have no supper. I give you fair warning.
I hate you.
Gently, young Benjamin.
Leave him to me, Dad.
Oh, you got the supper to get me, dear. I'll take him up. It's bed for that, me lad. That's not the way to behave to your ma'am. Come along.
I hate you.
Oh, God.
Well, where's supper? I'm hungry.
Let me put the fry in the pan. Supper's not the only job around here, you know.
Yeah, Ali. Where's Benji?
Where he deserves to be.
Oh, where's that?
In bed.
Well, what's up? What's he there for?
He lost his temper.
Ah, so you lost yours and sent him up. Did he have any supper?
Of course not.
No? No? Well, I'll see that he does then, that's all.
You'll do no such thing.
Who said so?
He stays there, food or no food, until he learns not to spit at his mother again.
Oh, will he? We'll see about that then. Benji, come on down.
Dad!
Go back, Benjamin. Go back at once.
Didn't you hear me tell him to come down?
Yes, and I tell him to go up again. And up he shall go until he's learned his manners.
So that's it.
Yep.
You asked for it.
Mom! David! Mind him, Jess.
Out of my way. And let that be a lesson to you, my lad.
Good evening, madam.
Good evening.
My name is Starling. I bought old Dr. Ramsden's practice. I've only been here a few days, but I thought I'd come round to ask you about a possible lease of the shooting.
Oh, I'm sure we could come to an arrangement, Doctor.
Forgive my mentioning it, ma'am, but I see you're in black.
Yes. I lost my father-in-law in May.
Oh, I'm sorry to hear that. And your husband?
He left some time ago. I don't blame him. He was a bit wild. His mother left him some money and it went to his head. We can't help ourselves.
So you're up here alone?
No, I've got my two boys, David and Benjamin, though they're young. 50 acres isn't much to shoot over.
Oh, I'm renting 12 trees, too. I shall drive up the hill and finish at your place.
There isn't much, I'm afraid, Doctor. I see a hare or two occasionally in an odd covey, but nothing much.
Perhaps you'd care to show me the boundaries of your land. I needn't go trespassing then.
Certainly. If you'd like to come this way...
Right.
I'll just put this bin in the barn. Shoo! Shoo! Go away with you. That's all you're getting till tomorrow. Go on, shoo!
Benjamin!
The Charmant Land ends by that row of elms there, Doctor.
I see. Do you get any snipe at all?
By the brook, I think. I've heard them say so. 12-treed land comes all the way from the village by the brook. Oh. You'd see them there, if anywhere.
Oh, sounds a hopeful spot. So you're keeping the farm by yourself, Mrs. Mortimer?
I want it for my sons. Why shouldn't I? Goodness, I couldn't do much worse than those before me. I do know that.
They're saying there's not much in land nowadays.
They've always said that. What's wrong with the land, I should like to know? It's the same land, the same weather, the same seasons. Everything's the same, except the people farming it. The people have changed, that's all. Mm. The land alone can't do much, can it? Look at this field. Now, this land lay fallow through sheer laziness. My father-in-law let it go completely. And now look at it. Oh, it's poisoned. Look at the weeds and twitch. 5 years won't see it clean again. It's always been the same. Always has been and always will. If you're not master of the land will be master of you. Nothing so sure as that. I only wish it could be.
It must be worrying for you with so little help.
Oh, nothing worries me much except accounts. And they frighten me rather. Do you know anything about them, Doctor?
A little.
Well, even if it's only a little, and you can tell me what it is, I should be thankful. I want to do things properly. I must. A farm is a business like anything else. If it isn't run properly, there's no hope for it.
I'll be glad to do all I can to help. But talking of accounts, I haven't settled mine for the shooting.
Oh, no. That doesn't matter now, Doctor. In the spring...
No. And I think that's what we agreed.
No, Doctor, I
must go now, Mrs. Mortimer, but we'll have a chat tomorrow about the farm accounts. I'll blow in about this time, if I may.
Of course, Doctor. Thank you. Good night.
Good night, Mrs. Mortimer.
Oh, shut up!
That's nice talk. Oh. Now stop quarreling, you two, and mind what you're saying. The doctor's just coming up the path.
I ain't quarreling with nobody.
All right, you're not quarreling, but that's enough. Hush, boy, do. Good evening, Doctor. Come in.
Good evening, Mrs. Mortimer. Hello, you two. No quarreling, I hope.
Oh, you're just in time, Doctor. I think you'd better sit between them.
Oh, very well. What are you staring at, young man?
Your gun.
Benjamin, you behave.
Yeah.
I'd be ashamed, I know.
What did he do?
Oh, you shut up, David. Ming, 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 magpie.
I want a gun.
Indeed. And is that the way to ask?
Oh, why can't I have one?
Ask the doctor.
Why can't I have one, Doctor? One like that?
Because it's dangerous. Because you're not old enough. Because they cost more money than you dream. Because you must have a license, and because you could never lift it.
I could lift it.
Oh, no, you don't. You must learn to take no for an answer, my lad.
I want one.
Now, come along, outside the pair of you. The doctor has come to help me with the account. Now, come on, hurry up.
No, bang, 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 bang.
Bit of a handful, those two, Mrs. Mortimer.
Yes, though they're good lads, really. But the one thing they need, they've never had, a father's discipline.
It must be very difficult for you. I expect they also lack companionship up here.
No, not really. There are the 12-trees. They have children, and the Sharmans. Their two sons are grown up, but they have a daughter, Sophie. She's 7. David's quite taken her recently. So they're not really alone. But you're right, it's not always easy.
Things will sort out, I dare say. Well, let's have a look at these accounts and see if we can sort them out, too.
Right. I can milk ours.
You dared.
That's all it is. You dare.
Who says so?
I do. Come on. We can do ours first and then go back to your place.
All right. I'll give you dare.
We'll see. Come on. This is the barn. You take Hetty, the black one there. She's easy. Oh, I'll take June. They seem to like you, David. That's nearly 3 gallons. You must have a way with you. I finish Peggy now, and that's the lot.
I'll take the buckets into the house for you.
Oh, that can wait a minute. I want to tell you. There's an old hen that nests up in the loft. Shall we go up and see if she's laid?
All right. But what a place to lay.
Yes. This way. Race you up. There she goes.
Hi.
Move that box. She'll lay anywhere. She laid in the chaff cover last week and the egg was smashed. My fingers aren't long enough. You try. Bend down and look and see if you can see it. No, wait a minute. I can touch it. Give me your hand.
No, I can't reach it. She must have laid a thin egg.
You should just feel my heart. It's going like an old threshing drum. You won't feel it beating there. Don't you know where a girl's heart is? Lower than that.
Sophie, I shall have to go now. Mother will be waiting for our milk.
No, don't go. Don't go. Come here, just for one moment. Then you can go. Afterwards. Don't go yet.
Well, I must. I told you, Mother's waiting for the milk.
I told you, you dared, didn't I? And I was right, too. You can do your milking by yourself.
Leave that old milk, Mum. Help me get my kit together. There's a war. A war, do you hear?
I heard. What war?
A war with Germany. The Kaiser's marched into Belgium. I'm joining up.
Your place is here, Benjamin.
I shall have to go. I'm a volunteer. That's what we're for, in case we go first. Well, don't you see? I shall have to go.
You're only one.
A few ones soon make an army.
You wouldn't like it if you hurt your mother. Wait till after harvest. Wait and see what happens. It may be all over. You must wait until after the harvest.
The parade ground was crowded yesterday, crowded. 50 chaps listed straight off.
Oh, Benjamin, please.
Oh. All right. I'll stop till we've carried, unless things are bad. But I'm going sooner or later. What about David? If things are bad, he'll have to go too.
Things won't get bad. It'll be over before we've ploughed.
That's what they're all saying, Mum. But you wait. Just you wait.
Well, that's the last time I wash in the old sink for a good while.
The last time?
Yes, Mum. I'm off tomorrow.
Tomorrow?
Yes, David, tomorrow. Call me early, Mother
dear. What a row. Folks will hear you in Staveston. Be quiet, for goodness sake.
Oh, tomorrow you'll be saying, oh, if only that boy was singing at the sink.
If you weren't so big, I'd give you something to sing for, I know.
Can't keep a good man down, Mum. We'll get up before daylight and be off, won't we, David?
We'll see.
I'll give you a knock.
David's place is here on the farm. And so is yours, Benjamin, if you could see it.
I see, said the blind man.
When are you going? I keep talking about going, but when?
Early in the morning, before the sun was rising.
Very well, then. If you want to go, you must go. But don't come grizzling home to me when your shirt isn't ready to put on. Or when your dinner isn't ready. Or when your socks need darning. I shan't be at home, my lad.
Would you join us at supper, David? It's very frugal, but we have no right to eat while others are suffering. Well,
thank you, Mrs. Twelvetree.
And where is your brother Benjamin now?
He's in France.
In France? Oh, how proud your mother must be of her son. And when you go, too.
Of course, you'll come and say goodbye to us when you do go, David.
Well, of course, Mr. Twelvetree.
when I go.
I think that's so noble. But it's what we would all do if we were able. If I were a man, to volunteer would send a thrill through my heart.
People are not all so easily stirred as you, Mother.
Prunella. Now, be quiet, my dear, while your father reads us the latest war news. I do feel it so good and important. David would like to hear it too, I feel sure.
I feel sure he would. Wouldn't you, Mr. Mortimer?
Now, look here, Prunella. David, if you go, I'll go.
Oh, Daddy!
Yes, Prunella. I'll go if he will. I mean it.
William. Oh, William.
Look up, David, my boy. Will you if I do?
Oh, why should I?
Ah.
Who spoke to you, Prunella? No one asked you to speak. Your father asked me a question, and I'll answer it when I've made up my mind. Auntie, come out and talk with me. Whatever you say, I'll do.
May I go, Mother?
I have nothing to say. Ask your father.
May I, Daddy?
Yes, Anthea. You may go with David.
Come along, Anthea. Which way should we go, Anthea?
Let's go down by the brook.
Do you want me to volunteer? Anthea, you do want me to, don't you?
Why should I want you to, David? Do you think this is the first I've heard about it? Don't you think they've been talking about you for weeks and weeks? Nothing but you and the war, and why didn't you go? Prunella won't let me sleep for talking about you.
Never mind your sister. She doesn't understand anyway. None of them do. If your father joins up, Auntie, what will you do?
I don't know. He talks of selling out. Mother has money, but we lose it on the farm. We 12 Trees were the last people who ought to have been farmers. If Father goes to the war, we shall sell up, perhaps, and go into lodgings or rent a house somewhere. I don't know. I don't care much.
Does he want to go?
He thinks it's right. They all think it's right.
If I go, Anthea, will you marry me? My mother would have you to live with her.
Oh, David. They'd never let me. When would you go?
I'll stay a week. If we got married, my mother might buy your place and put us into it. One big farm. All your fields, right down here, and all ours up to the road. Well, think of it.
Would she do it? Well,
she'd do it if she could.
But could she?
Well, you never know about Mother. She's deep. She's got her head screwed on the right way, don't you, Fred? Since my father left her, well, she's had to use her head.
Don't you ever hear of your father?
Never.
Doesn't she speak of him?
Well, she told us about him, Benjamin and me. And then it were finished. Once she said a thing, she said it. She's never said another word. Anthea.
Yes?
Tell your parents I'll go.
Oh, I've no patience with them. You're not beholden to them for every step you take.
I'll stop a week. The roots want hoeing.
They do, badly.
Yeah, the wheat ought to be rolled as well.
It ought.
I might do that, too.
I should.
A week's a long time. You can do a lot in a week.
Yes. You can do a lot in a week.
Here's your tea, David. Oh, it's good to see you.
It's nice being on leave, Mum. Thanks.
Oh, what's all this about money, eh?
Well, you've heard me speak of Mrs. Arbuthnot.
What, that old girl you used to work for?
Yeah, now listen. I received a letter from a lawyer yesterday telling me she'd left me some money. And there's me not even knowing she was dead, poor soul.
Oh, how much is the money?
If I told you, you wouldn't believe me.
20 or
30 quid, I expect.
My goodness gracious, I'll give you 20 or 30 quid.
20,000.
What, do you think she was a millionaire?
Well, if it isn't 20,000, it's not worth having.
Then you don't think 1,000 is worth having?
1,000?
1,000. Cash and securities.
1,000? Why, the old... Now, you'll do something with that, I should hope.
Do something?
Well, buy some land. A bit more pasture. Some more cows.
We'll see.
You've got to strike out, Mum. If we're going to have a farm, let's have a farm. And not a molehill. What can you do with 50 acres?
Have you been up to see Anthea? She's been asking about you.
Yes, I went this morning. I think she's ill, Mum.
Ill?
Yes. They're starving themselves, those 12 trees.
Starving?
Well, since Mr. 12 Tree was killed at the front, the three of them just sit there knitting and don't eat enough to keep a mouse alive.
But why? Well, why?
They think it's patriotic.
Patriotic? Oh, I've no patience with such folks. I've no patience with them.
This'll give you an idea, ma'am. Look. She baked that little bun for me. No. And that's something special. They're just starving. The farm's going to ruin. They've got no cattle now. And the wheat's never been hoed since it was drilled in.
Oh.
What are you going to do with this money?
The money's all right where it is.
Why don't you buy their farm, 12 Trees?
Buy it?
Yes, buy it. Anthea says she'll marry me, and she can come and live here till the war's over. And then we can live at 12 Trees. And I'll farm that side, and you farm this.
They don't want to sell, do they?
They can't farm. They know that. They'd be only too glad to sell.
It wants thinking about. I should want to be clear about the rights and wrongs of a big thing like that.
Yes, I know, but I want you to do it. Promise me you'll buy it. Promise.
All right, David, lad. I'll buy it. I promise. If you'd like to help with the chickens and the milk, Anthea, you can. I'd be glad, in fact. And I'll pay your wages, same as I should other folks.
I'd really love to help, Mrs. Mortimer, but I don't want any wages.
Oh, now come. Work's work and it's worth money.
No.
There's nothing wrong about working for money, is there? If it's right for a man, it's right for a woman, I should think.
I suppose it is.
No suppose about it. It's just give and take. Now, what can you do? Can you feed up and milk?
I can feed, but I can't milk. We never did a thing ourselves on the farm.
Well, you do what you can, then. You'll soon pick things up.
I hope so. I'll get along to those calves.
Just a minute, Anthea.
Yes?
You're not worrying about that boy, are you? If I catch you worrying 1 minute about him, I'll warm you. If he's in the front line, he's in it. And all the fretting in the world won't make it different. You must take things as they come. You can't help them or keep them back. So just don't worry.
I'll try.
You'd better. Now go and see to your calves.
All right.
I'd be most grateful if you'd examine her, Dr. Starling. Anthea's my daughter-in-law, and it's my duty to my son.
Sounds like undernourishment to me.
I thought as much, and that's patriotism. What can I do for her? Oh, is it serious?
It could be serious. She's at an awkward age.
This humbugging war, too.
Does she worry?
She broods, and she thinks, always having presentiments about something. If she could work in the garden, it might occupy her mind, don't you think?
A garden, of course. Let her sow things, more of those lovely sweet peas and marigolds and poppies. I'd like to paint the garden this summer.
Anthea paints a bit herself.
Does she? Then perhaps she could join me sometimes. Don't ask her. Drop a hint, quite offhand. Here she comes now. Not a word, remember. She's carrying a telegram.
The postman. I saw him in the lane. It's David. I knew. You'd better leave us alone, Dr. Starling.
I will, but I won't go. I'll be outside if you need me. Just give me a call.
Yes?
Mrs. Mortimer.
Yes?
Good afternoon, ma'am. I'm a government official. I understand you have 15 acres of fallow land.
Yes, what of it?
Well, you will appreciate, ma'am, that with a war on, every acre of land ought to be yielding.
I have heard of the war. Both my sons went away to it, and one won't be coming back. What do you want me to do with this field?
Plow it, ma'am, plow it.
How am I to plow it?
With a plow, woman.
Oh, and will you drive it? A plough wants a man behind it. I've enough to plough now without turning to fallow land. The government takes the men away from us and sends them to their death and then expects the land to plough itself.
But, ma'am, the government...
What do you know about the land? Nothing. You've sat on your backside in an office all your life, and in 5 minutes you think you can learn what it takes a lifetime to learn? Who told you to come here anyway?
It's my duty.
Duty? If you want to do your duty, come and strip your coat off and plow the 15-acre field. I'll pay you well.
What do I know about plowing? I'll send you some German prisoners. They'll plow for you.
Prisoners? I'll neither plow the field nor have prisoners. While I can stand up, I'll run this farm myself. And when I want prisoners and advice, I'll ask for it. Not until...
My good woman, it's a government order, and if you don't obey, you will suffer.
Suffer? Suffer!
Hello, Anthea. Did you have a nice walk?
Yes, thank you. The doctor was down by the brook shooting.
Oh, yes?
We had a chat.
Oh, didn't you ask him in?
Yes, he came in for a moment before he left.
Oh.
Would you mind if... He wants me to marry him.
Gracious child. He must be almost 50.
I know. What's the matter, Mrs. Mortimer?
Oh, nothing. Nothing. Do you like him?
Oh, yes. But I'll do whatever you say.
Do you want to marry him?
Yes.
Well, if you want to do it, there's no more to be said. You must do as you think best. I shan't stand in your way. Lay the table for me, will you? The fry's nearly done.
Well, well, Mum.
How are you, Benjamin, lad?
Fine, fine. Still driving the old trap. Same old cart cushions, same old whip. Why don't you burn them?
I'll burn you. You'd keep going for a month or more, you great horse. What have they been feeding you on out there? The size of you.
Ah, that's better.
Get up, gal. Well, it looks as if I shall be able to sack all the men now you're home for good. You'll do the work of 50.
Sack them, buy that tractor. You thought any more about the tractor?
Tractor? Oh, I've plenty else to think about. We got horses, haven't we?
Horses? Who wants horses? I want some on wheels. Wheels are the coming thing. Everything's going to be on wheels. We're all going to be on wheels. Just you mark my words. Same old country.
Glad to be back, aren't you, Benjamin?
There she is. Same old farm.
Same old farm, indeed. It's twice as big.
Well, same old farm, only a bit bigger. Same old mulligan going on anyway.
You must remember, we haven't had the men.
Wheels will soon change all that, you see. As I told you just now, we'll soon be on wheels, you and I, Mum. It's the coming thing.
Come on, gal. Get up, go on.
There. Isn't she a beauty, Mum? Sit in there. Go on. See how you like it.
A tractor? Don't be a silly boy. We can't afford a thing like that.
Go on. What do you think I brought you to the agricultural show for?
When you have a farm of your own, it'll be time to do as you like and have as many machines as you please. Not until...
You know what we want? A new drill. Look at them old horse drills of ours. Now, look at the rows you're drilling one bout with that thing.
Your father sowed his wheat broadcast.
And he had 10 quarter 1 year, I remember him saying. There isn't a man in the show that's seen 10 quarter.
Now, there's a time saver for you. Now, all you do is you connect the flexible pipe on there, and any water that collects while you're ditching can be pumped out as you work. Hey, how's that for a gadget? No more aching elbows at the sawing stool. 30 logs a minute, clean as a whistle. Just look at it. You know what that is? A kid could work it. It reaps and ties and throws out in a jiffy. Oh, come on, Mum. Say we'll have one. Come on. It'll save its costing 2 harvests. Come on, say we'll have it. You'll never regret it.
There you are, Mum. What did I tell you? No more worries. The old field done in a trice and ready for collecting. Oh, she's a beauty. Thanks a million.
She certainly is. You and me, Benji, are going to make this a grand farm.
Yes. And now you can get the flags out.
And what for?
For me.
And now watch the jape.
Going to be married.
You mean that?
Cut my throat if I tell a lie. Here, well, you needn't be so sniffy about it, need you?
I don't think I am sniffy, but it's a bit sudden, surely.
Yeah, what's the matter? It's my business. I mean, I'm marrying the girl.
And who is the girl?
Name's Ada. She's all right.
Oh, I hope she is. When did you meet her?
Last week at the dance.
A dance? Are you going to bring her home? I think I should be allowed to see the sort of girl my son's going to marry all in a hurry.
Well, she's crossing the field behind you now, Mum. She's invited herself. Hello, Ada.
Hello, Benji.
Benji. And she hasn't known him a week.
Mother, this is Ada. Ada, my mother.
How do you do?
Ada, eh? Why are you in such a hurry to get married? That's what I want to know.
Oh, we want to.
I'm sure you do.
Well, what's the use of waiting? Once you start waiting, you wait forever. You don't catch me at that game.
I can imagine that. Where are you going to live?
Well, we thought you'd have us here, Mum.
Oh, tied to your mother's apron strings.
Well, you came to live here when you were first married.
Yes, and I learnt my lesson.
Yeah, well, where are we to live?
You're big enough to answer that for yourself. You should think of these things beforehand. If I put you in 12 trees,
aye?
Could I trust you to look after things? Could Ada do the work?
Oh, Mum, you're
don't absent. Say you would just for the sake of saying so. The farm was to have been David's. He was to have farmed that side and me this. Could you farm it?
On my own?
You'd both come into it when I'm dead in any case, so I'd better by half make it over to you while I'm alive. And then I can see you reaping the benefit.
Oh, we'll farm it, eh, Ada? We'll show you how to farm.
It's a big thing.
Oh, you'll see. When you see me across that hill ploughing a whole damn field, and the time it takes old Rook to do a headland, your eyes will drop out. Oh, you'll see me. And at harvest time, I'll cut my own wheat in the morning and yours in the afternoon. Farming? You don't know how to farm. And as for the fallow field you're always on about, we'll settle that one too.
Will you, my lad? I wonder.
Oh, shut up. Damn kid makes me sick. Nothing but ball, ball, ball all day long.
Have you fed him, Ada?
Fed him? I'm always feeding him. He bowls when he wants to be fed and bowls again when you've fed him. Oh, it's sickening.
Shall I nurse him for a bit?
Oh, I don't care.
Come along then, love.
Kids don't give you a minute's peace.
Don't I know it. There, love. That better? How are the hens, Ada? Are they laying at all?
Laying? Don't get an egg apiece for breakfast.
Oh, what's the matter with them?
Oh, ask me another.
What feed do you give them?
Feed? Oh, they take potluck most days. They find enough in the yard.
They want a bran mash these cold mornings?
I dare say, but who's going to get a bran mash here with 2 kids to feed and dress? Not me, thank you.
Has that sow pigged yet?
Sow? Oh, well, we sold that.
Sold it? That sow was in pig. What the nation did he sell it for?
Oh, the tractor wanted new parts or something, and Ben thought it was more important than the sow, so he sold her.
Well, he's sharp. He could have got credit for the parts, couldn't he?
He's finished getting credit.
But that sow was worth a weight in solid gold. She'd have soon had 12 or 14 pigs besides more litters.
Oh, well, it's done with now. Can't say I'm sorry either.
I can't stand the rotten things.
There's not much you can stand, is there?
No, there ain't, and I don't care who knows it. If I've another winner in this place, I shall go scatty. Muck, muck, muck. Oh, nobody to talk to, and kids bawling all day long, up to our necks in debt. I am sick of it.
In debt? But what's Benjamin been doing?
Doing? What can you do with a place like this? We shall make it pay if we lived here till doomsday. Farming don't pay nowadays. It's finished.
You had a free start. I was hoping you'd make a go of it between you.
How? That's what I want to know.
How? Work. That's the only thing on the land. Work and patience and more work. Here, take the babe. I'll be going now. I want a word with Benjamin.
Oh, you can save yourself the trouble. He's gone off.
Gone where to?
If you must know, he's gone about some partnership in a motor bus. He's going to run from all the villages to the market. That's what we're selling up for.
Market Square! Market Square!
Thanks for the ride, Benjamin.
Oh, that's all right, Mum. It's on the house.
I pays like everyone else. Take it. I hope you're all right, my boy.
Oh, can't grumble.
How are the children?
Benny's meddling. How's yourself? You don't look too good.
Oh, I'm all right. Had a fall on the farm, that's all. Shall I go see him?
Feed yourself.
What time will you be home for tea?
4.
I'll come down about then.
Bye, Mum.
It's you.
Yes, Ada. I told Benjamin I should be coming down.
Oh, did you? Well, he ain't here yet.
He said young Benny was bad. Thought I'd come and see how he was. Is he better?
Oh, he ain't half as bad as he likes to make out.
Can I come in?
Come in if you like.
Well, what's the matter with Benny? Oh, what's the matter, love?
Oh, don't be so daft, boy. Let her look at your ear. Oh, he's a damn nuisance. He won't let you touch him. I've had enough straight.
Let me look, Benny. Let Gran have a look. I'm going for a doctor to that child at once. Why didn't you send for him before?
He wouldn't let me do anything. He wouldn't let me touch him.
He let me look. And he'll let a doctor look, I know.
Hello? You off already?
Yes, I'm off, Benji, for the doctor.
I told you you look middling.
Me middling? I'm all right. It's that child of yours. You ought to be ashamed of yourself.
What's that? I know what's wrong with him. Without asking you, you leave him to me.
Leave him to you? I should think he's been left to you long enough. Why, that child's not even clean.
What?
If he'd been clean, this wouldn't have happened. Ada, why don't you wash the child?
Who said I don't wash him? Who said I don't? You interfere too much by half. If you'd given us a lift up when we needed it, we shouldn't have been here. But you never came near, did you? You took damn good care to keep away. I know your sort. Telling me I don't wash the child? We don't want your help. We're as good as you any day.
Don't you mutter at me, my boy. I've given you chances enough for a dozen men. You're big and lazy, though. Too big and too lazy to wash your own children. That's what you are.
What's that? You get out before I do something. I wish I hadn't. Go on.
Don't you lose your temper with me. I'm going.
Who's losing their temper?
Tell her straight I won't. I've had about enough. Tell her straight.
Get out of this house and don't come back.
I'll go when I'm ready.
And you better be ready quick.
I'd be ashamed of myself shouting about.
Oh, go on. Get out. How many more times do you want telling?
Yes, Rook, thanks.
Saint, you know. What's the matter? You look middling.
Me? I'm all right. What's the matter with me? I'm all right, man.
You want to be careful at your age. It's tidy hot, you know.
What if it is? I've got things to do.
I can't bother with the heat.
All right, missus, all right. The bad penny's returned.
Jeff!
Ah, you may well stare. Waking day.
You've been sleeping rough.
Hey.
Where'd you sleep last night?
Hey.
I said, you've been sleeping rough.
Best I could find.
Can't you hear?
Hey. Oh, I've been a bit deaf this 2 years. Ain't done a mess, you see. New gates, new poultry houses.
Now you've come, are you going to stop?
Hey. Oh, I come up to see you got a bit of a jacket to give away.
What made you creep back after all this time? You can stop and have a bite if you care. It's cold, but you're welcome. You can go and wash while I dish up if you like.
Oh, I shan't bother. Bit of muck, more or less, wouldn't hurt me.
Just as you please. Well, it's ready if you are.
Ah. Bit the boys about?
Benjamin's married. Mm. He's been with a bus company. Now he's in the motor business in Stavithton.
Yeah.
He was restless after the war. Felt he couldn't take to farming again. They nearly lost their boy, Benny. But he's better now.
Where's David?
He was killed in the war.
Hey?
He's dead!
War?
Yes. Well, there's plenty there. Take more than that.
Oh, yeah. Don't mind if I do.
You'd better eat it all. I don't want any.
Ah.
Go on.
You don't look very lively.
I'm all right. I'm a bit older than when you saw me last, that's all.
I am such a chicken myself.
You'd better stop here. You could do light work and I'd pay you. Then if you don't like it, you can leave off and draw your money.
Right, yes. You're the boss.
What's the matter, man? Oh. Good gracious, what's the matter with you?
Hey, give me a drink. It should be all right then.
Oh. What's the matter with you?
It's that damn gas. I got it. It's got it proper. Thank you.
Oh, then you went. I'll get some tea. Want to look at the paper?
Oh, it's no good. I can't see. As blind as a bat. Just make it the picture bits, that's all. Rum times.
Yes.
What are we coming to?
I'm sure I don't know.
We'll never be the same, will it? Land's in a poor way.
The land's all right. It's the people on the land. The land's still the same as ever. Can't you do anything for that everlasting trembling?
Give me another drop of brandy.
There you are.
Ah.
Well, I'll say goodnight. I get up betimes.
I shan't be long myself. Good night.
Is that you, Anthea?
Yes, but you must rest.
How many eggs today?
Nearly 40.
40? Oh, good gracious. What's Jess doing with them? Not an egg to 3 hens.
You mustn't talk.
I don't care. Where is he? Fetch him up. I want to talk to him.
But you mustn't.
I'll get up if you don't fetch him.
Promise to close your eyes if I do.
All right. All right. Forty eggs. Were you having a nap?
Ah. How'd you feel, me darling?
That's right, Zell, let me be. Have you done that ploughing?
Hey? Oh, the fallow land, yes. We made a start.
A start? You ought to be finished. I want that wheat in.
Ah, that'll be time enough.
It ought to have been ploughed a month back. If you don't plough that field, we shall lose it. You know what it used to be? Why don't you do it? Why don't you?
Now, you've talked enough. Lie still now. You must go, Jess.
Hey?
It's time you went.
I'll go.
Now, try to sleep.
He's been drinking again, hasn't he?
You really mustn't talk.
There may be legal difficulties, but I'd like you to have the farm, Anthea. You and the doctor. You would have had it if David had come back from the war. Jess'll drink it away. I know he will. You see how his hands keep trembling? That's drink. He told me it was gas. But it's drink. I know.
When the doctor comes, I shall make him give you a sleeping draught.
I must...
You must stop talking.
How many eggs did you say? How many?
Nearly 100. I found another basin full.
Oh, that's more like it. Oh, so you're here, Doctor. I don't want a sleeping draught. Many birds this year?
Not many. The spring was too wet.
I want you to have the farm. You and Anthea. I want you to have the farm. It'll be nice for you. The land's all right. It wants working, that's all. Has Jess been ploughing that fallow field? If it isn't ploughed, we shall lose it. We shall. Lift me up. Lift me up. I want to see if he's been ploughing it. Lift me. Lift.
Anthea, my dear, go and sit in the car while I tell Jess.
How is she, Doctor?
She's gone, Jess.
Hey?
She's gone. She was asking about the fallow field. She asked me to tell you to plough it up and have wheat on it.
Oh. Well, that fallow land's no good. What good's wheat? Anyway, they won't buy it. It's no good at all. Land's no good.
She wanted to leave the place to Anthea and me, but there may be legal difficulties. If you care to sell, though, we'll buy it.
Hey, I could do that. It's my place. Anyway, the land's no good, I tell you. It's no good at all. Well, just look at it. No one's ever beaten that yet. You'd be wasting your labour.
I see. Well, come along, old chap. It's cold out here. It's time to go.
Yes. You're right, Doctor. It's time to go.
The Fallow Land, the novel by H.E. Bates, was adapted for radio and produced by David H. Godfrey. The part of Deborah was played by Denise Breyer, and that of Jess by Jeffrey Matthews. David as a boy, Alwyn Griffiths. David as a man, John Forrest. Benjamin as a boy, Sandra Clark. Benjamin as a man, David Valla. Anthea, Julie Hallam. Ada, Sandra Clark. Dr. Starling, Peter Williams. Mrs. Arbuthnot, Joan Sanderson. Mrs. Mortimer, Kathleen Helm. Mr. Mortimer, Charles Simon. Alma Wolstenholme, Jane Knowles. Sophie Sharman, Greta Gourier. Mrs. Twelvetree, Hilda Schroeder. Mr. Twelvetree and Rook, Brian Haynes. Prunella Twelvetree and Baby Benny, Alwyn Griffiths. Government official and Duff, Anthony Hall. Fairground attendant, William Eadle.
Joan Sanderson is now appearing in Habeas Corpus at the Lyric Theatre, London. Tomorrow afternoon at 4 o'clock, you're invited to enter another world, the world of Winnie the Pooh and the House at Pooh Corner. Bernard Cribbins will be the storyteller in a selection of some of these immortal stories by A.A. Milne, which have been abridged for radio by Barbara Slay. In part one, the story begins and Piglet meets a heffalump. We're introduced to Winnie the Pooh, and Piglet and Christopher Robin unmask the horrible heffalump. Bernard Cribbins has his own unique style of reading, and he manages to encompass the entire range of characters, making them all live in their own right. The Best of Pooh, stories from Winnie the Pooh and the House at Pooh Corner, begins tomorrow afternoon at 4 o'clock. Now the weather forecast for tomorrow. Most of England, Wales, Northern Ireland and southwest Scotland will have a cloudy day with periods of rain, which may be heavy at times with local thunderstorms. Parts of southern England will become brighter later. Eastern Scotland and northeast England will be rather cloudy, but mainly dry with hill and coastal fog patches. Northwest Scotland will be dry with sunny intervals. It will be rather cool in most places. The outlook? Rain at times in most areas, but some sunny intervals, mostly in the southeast. Generally cool. Now after Big Ben, the news, read by Brian Hudson.
BBC Radio News at 10 o'clock. President Nixon is a little better, though his doctors say he's still a very sick man. They'd like him to get away to the sunshine of California. In Belfast, four people were hurt in a pub explosion tonight, but it could have been much worse if the bomb hadn't been spotted. Mozambique. Journalists have been taken to a village said to be the one mentioned in the massacre allegations. The British Grand Prix at Silverstone had to be restarted after a multiple crash at 170 miles an hour. Golf. Tom Weisskopf of the United States is the 1973 Open champion.